Friends, I welcome you to today's session. Today we are going to learn 5 very important life-changing habits of highly successful people. Friends, we become what our habits make us. We are sum total of our habits, and 95% of our life's results depend upon the kinds of habits that we have. Let us understand that it is very easy to form bad habits, but it becomes very, very difficult to live with them. On the other hand, it is very difficult at times to create good habits, but once we have formed them, once they have become a part of our life, it becomes very easy to live with them, and it actually becomes very, very rewarding. So, let us start with it. Number one, have goals worth fighting for. And number two, focus on widely important goals. So why I have taken both of them collectively is that both of them talk about the goals. Friends, you might have seen when we start our day, on the previous day we feel that there are so many important things that I have to do tomorrow. But when that tomorrow comes, normally we waste whole of our day in all trivial tasks, and at the end of the day we realize that I wanted to do this, I wanted to do that, there were so many important things that I wanted to do but I couldn't. Secondly, sometimes we have a long-term goal and we want to work towards it, and we want to take small steps every day towards its achievement. After a month or so, we realize that I haven't moved even a step forward. So when we look back, we feel that somewhere we waste our time in other activities rather than focusing on the important goals. Why does this happen? It is very important to understand. It happens because the goals which are important to us, they are not always present in our mind. Mostly our mind is occupied by other things which are not important but which seem urgent to us. So what is the way to ensure that we always remember our important goals? The best way, the best step forward that we can take is that review your goals regularly. Write them on paper. I had created a video earlier in which I had shared with you that only 3% people have clear written goals. 97% don't have. That is where the problem lies. So, write the goals, review them every day if possible for 5 minutes in the morning and for 5 minutes in the evening, so that they always remain in focus, so that we always remember them, and whenever we start our day, we focus on widely important goals rather than wasting our day once again. So in that way, we will be able to focus much better, we will be motivated, we will be much more passionate, we will have some purpose in our life, and hence we will make our days really productive. Coming on to habit number 3, it is that we should act on lead measures. So take action, act on lead measures, focus on lead measures rather than lag results. So what lead measures are? These are the steps that we need to take to achieve our goal. For example, if I want to reduce weight, the lead measures will be, I will exercise, I will monitor my diet, I will cut the sweets, and I will take other steps. Lag results will be the results whether my weight is reducing as much as I want or it is not. So, the results will always lag. They will take some time. So, rather than getting demotivated, keep focused on the lead measures. Keep taking those actions, keep taking those steps. Results will automatically follow. Habit number 4 is, you should keep a compelling scorecard. Friends, again, here we will take an example of a cricket match. Suppose you go to watch a cricket match in the stadium and the match begins. The whole stadium is full of people. Now when the match starts, you realize that nobody is showing you the score. There is no scoreboard. You don't know how many overs have been bowled. You don't know how many runs have been scored. You don't know what is the target for the other team. You don't know that where the match is going and what the actual condition is. So, will you be interested in watching such a match? I don't think that after 10, 15 or 20 minutes or maybe at the max 1 hour, there will be anybody left inside the stadium. Why is it so? Because there is no goal clarity. There is no clarity of the path that how that event is progressing. So you don't know anything, you don't know where you have to go, you don't know how much you have achieved. And hence, you lose the interest and you quit, you move out of the stadium and you don't want to watch that match again. Similarly, in life, keep a personal scoreboard. Note your goals, note what you need to do, note down how much you have achieved. Note down that what was the time that you had allocated to that task and whether have you achieved it or you haven't. So once you have a complete scoreboard of your personal progress, you will be much more interested in your day-to-day tasks. You will be much more interested, motivated and passionate about your work, and that will give you a challenge that yes, next time I will put in more effort so that I don't skip, so that I achieve better, I do better than before. So, habit number 4, you should keep a compelling scoreboard. Last but not the least, it says control actions and control your life. Friends, you are not your body, you are your mind. A mind differentiates one person from the other person. And so, whatever actions we take, that differentiate a successful person from a failure. So, we need to monitor our actions, we need to take actions, because even if you have the world's knowledge in your mind, but you don't implement it, you don't take the actions, you don't take those actions which are necessary for the accomplishment of your life's goals, your life will never change. You will never achieve what you want to achieve in your life. So that's all for today. I hope this session would have been of some help to you. If you feel so, kindly subscribe to the channel and share this video with your family and friends so that they also benefit from it. Thank you so much for being with me till the end. We will meet very soon in another session. Till then.